Hello everyone, myself Naini Garg, DST Inspire Fellow working at CSIR CSIO Chandigarh. My research interests include fabrication of sensing electrodes for the detection of environmental toxic pollutants such as volatile organic compounds like ammonia, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide and heavy metal ions like lead, cadmium, mercury. Today in this video, I'll be discussing about holography and the principle on which it works, the applications for which holograms can be used, and further towards the end of the video, we'll see small demonstration of the holospecs, which is a form of hologram. So let's see what holography is. Holography, it is taken from Greek words, that is holo and graphy. Holo means complete, graphy means recording. So, combining both the terms, we get holography, means the complete recording of an image of an object. Now, let's see how it's different from normal photography. What is the difference between holography and the normal photography? In normal photography, we are just recording the 2D image of an object. Only the intensity of the light that is traveling towards the object and reflecting towards your eyes is being recorded in the form of intensity. But in case of hologram, we get the 3D image of an object. That is, both intensity as well as phase is getting recorded. So it's basically a 3D imaging technique that is used to record the 3D image of an object. Now, the holography process is divided into two. That is, recording the hologram, then reconstructing the hologram in order to view the object. So, for this, first and the foremost important part is the light source. So, what is a light source? It's basically the stream of photons, massless packet of energy that is traveling with a wave-like property with the speed of light. These stream of photons, when they strike with an object, it gets reflected into our eyes and we are able to see an object. So now let's see the instrumentation to record and reconstruct the hologram. So for recording of the hologram, as you can see in the above image, we require a light source, that is a laser source. It is being used here. Since we are recording the phase difference, so we have to take a source that is coherent in nature. So we are taking laser instead of ordinary light. In this, we are using a beam splitter, whose function is to split the incoming beam of light into two. One will be called as a reference beam and other will be called as an object beam. The object beam will be allowed to fall on the object whose image is to be recorded. The waves falling on the different parts of the object will reflect back and falls onto the photographic plate as shown in the figure. So now we have two beams that are falling onto the plate. So these beams will either interfere with each other in constructive manner or in the destructive manner. Constructive means when crust and trough of both the waves, these overlap each other, it results into the constructive interference. Whereas the opposite case, that is when crust it overlaps onto the trough or the trough it overlaps onto the crust, it results into the destructive interference. Based on this, an interference pattern, it is being recorded onto the photographic plate in the form of dark and bright fringes. Now, once the hologram it is recorded, second diagram, it shows the reconstruction of the image from the hologram. Now, in order to reconstruct the image from the hologram, that is, it is since the hologram it contains the interference pattern, we need to decode the interference pattern to get the image. So for this, we are using the laser beam, same laser beam that we used during the recording of the this hologram. When this laser beam, it is made to fall on the this hologram, then the diffraction pattern it is obtained. In some direction we'll get maxima, as the secondary waves they interfere constructively, and in some direction we'll get minima when they interfere with each other destructively. So the observer, that is the eye of a human being, would be able to see the object in that direction along with the which the maxima is ऑब्टेन, जिस डायरेक्शन में हमें मैक्सिमम मिलेगा उस डायरेक्शन में ऑब्जर्वर ऑब्जेक्ट को व्यू कर पाएगा. सो दिस इज हाउ वी कैन सी द 3D इमेज ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट बाय यूजिंग होलोग्राम एज अ डायफ्रेक्शन ग्रेटिंग. Now let's see the small demonstration of the same.
When anyone tries on a pair of our Holiday Specs 3D glasses, the number one reaction is, wow, this is absolutely incredible. How did they do that? It's simple. We put a little bit of holiday magic in all the 3D glasses we make. At American Paper Optics, our exclusive Holiday Specs glasses offer a one-of-a-kind optical experience like you've never seen before. A surprise for your eyes, our 3D Christmas glasses will instantly become a holiday favorite for everyone around. Holiday Specs have patented holographic lenses that bend light, creating stunning holiday images from every bright point of light. It's absolutely mind-blowing and amazing and brilliant and fun. We could go on. So put on the glasses, look at any point of light, and watch the glasses magically transform your ordinary Christmas lights into a dazzling strand of holiday images. It's Christmas in 3D. And with a large assortment of stock designs ready for you to order, there is literally something for everyone. That's right, the magic is in the glasses. Watch how our 3D glasses miraculously bend light into amazing images, like snowmen, reindeer, gingerbread men, candy canes, and even Santa himself. After selling over 20 million Holiday Specs glasses around the world, our goal is to continue to spread joy and happiness with the gift of 3D. So don't wait. Order what toy magazines are calling the must-have holiday item of the season, making the ultimate perfect stocking stuffer. And if you want them for your store, we've got you covered as well. Holiday Specs retail Christmas glasses are easy to sell and come complete with their own interactive point-of-purchase displays. So let the festivities begin.
I hope you might have gained something from this video and this might have inculcated some research interest in you. If you like the video, click on like button and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching the video. Have a nice day.